So here's our next segment called Ask the Experts.
Believe it or not, that's us.
Yeah, even though we could not pronounce ask very well. Okay, so here we are. Now, a lot of people ask, Nick Walker, what is the deal with power and current? I feel like I never use current and I'm fine.
Yeah,
now,
what is current?
Yeah, what does current even do? Really simply, before we get into like our graphics and things, if you can think of the laser tube like a gun, when you're on low current, you're shooting a low amount of bullets. When you're on high current, you're shooting a lot of bullets. And then the power is the size of bullets in which you're using.
I just want to go...
I see the scene from Commando with Arnold with both guns. So we actually have a couple graphics that our producer Charles put together for you so we can kind of show the demonstration. So first we're going to talk about power. Now, the laser power is really just the intensity and the amount of pure energy that's coming to the machine. So when you go from low to high power, the size of the beam doesn't change, the pulse rate of the beam doesn't change, just the amount of energy that's getting to the beam, and that in turn is how much energy is getting applied to your material. So your power setting is the most common setting used. It's how most people dial in to get their cut settings or dial in specific vector marking. Now we should mention that as we talk about vector, where we talk about current and power, we're only talking about vector cutting and vector marking, because
it has nothing to do with raster.
Absolutely. So this wouldn't apply to any type of rasterization at all. So as we move on to current, now current is really the pulse rate of the laser. So it's how many times your laser is firing as it moves across the site. So we use like kind of a frequency representation there to see that like low current, it's a lower pulse rate than a high current. You have more of the laser firing at your material. Now, if you want to think about this for a practical sense, as you're cutting, you're going to want to dial in your power and speed settings first, and then you can always fine tune with the current. So if you're getting a bit of charring on the edge of your wood, let's say turning down the power one more percentage or a couple more percentage actually doesn't cut through. Well, you found the sweet spot for power. If you want to get that like nice golden brown char, what do you do?
Play with that current. Lower the current. And actually, if you do paper, I think it's really important to see that difference, because you can see the different serrations actual on paper when you play with the current.
Absolutely. So
Monica mentioned that in the comments that she's been using it for paper.
Yes. Paper, look at Monica was just, maybe we should have Monica on.
Yeah.
And Monica, you can just start doing the show.
All right.
Okay, we'll be back. Just kidding, Monica, great point. Paper, I think, is the most important place where you start dialing in your current, because it's so delicate. Another good
that's
one.
That's where I learned it.
Absolutely.
Like, and that's why I learned it.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I was like, when I first started, I was
all
in the
power.
Same boat.
Yep.
I was like, well, what's that about?
Yeah, absolutely. And another delicate things are things like lace. Other delicate, like papers, are where people are doing personalized gifts or greeting cards or invitations. A lot of that paper is very thin and delicate.
Mm-hmm.
Great use of it. I also noticed that when you're doing leather, it's a great way to minimize the char on leather when you're doing cuts with that.
Especially less dense.
Absolutely,
leather.
Yeah. And we're talking like a thin leather that doesn't have much hide to it.
Yeah, very pliable.
Absolutely. Okay, so really, if we want to kind of summate this as to when and how you use it, power is like your large dial that you want to get very close to.
Yes.
And current is what you can use to really
tweak it,
absolutely dial it into exactly what you need.
Kind of like a clock in the minutes, right? Hour, get that hour right, and then dial in the minutes.
Absolutely. So many people in their applications, they'll never use current because they just have power and speed that works well. I can see a lot of people with acrylic doing this, but as you move into thicker acrylic, even a quarter inch acrylic will give you this problem. You'll notice that a little bit of the kerf has a little bit of a bow to it. By dialing in the current, you can actually minimize the amount of kerf when you dial in current, even on acrylic.
So Monica said, just ship her out and.
Oh, no problem. So
yeah.
we'll get that approval put through our executives, and we'll see how that turns out.
We just put her in luggage and then under the plane's cheaper.
As long as you don't mind flying under the plane, I think we can work this out
sometime
today.
So we got a couple questions for the experts.
Of course. What questions do we have?
First, we've got, are current and power settings affected by the laser tube wattage?
A bit, but no different than it would be the effectiveness of the laser tube. So if you have 100 power, 100 current on a 40 watt tube, that's obviously different than 100 power and 100 current on a 90 watt tube. So as you figure out power settings, how they're a little different on higher wattage tube, you'll notice the current also has With the 90 watt tube, I'd say you have more playroom. You have more like ability to dial in because there's more. It seems like more effective steps as you dial in percentage and current.
So at a certain point, the actual 45 watt tube will start to piddle out.
Right.
With a pro tube, it seems as though it can go very low and
absolutely
still be effective. And I mean, it's got a wider range in general, so it's spread out.
Yeah.
And the last question is, why is the current setting not used in engravings?
Say that again?
Why don't you have the option for current settings when you're doing engravings?
Very good question. So when you're doing engravings, the laser's already taken into account current and using current a bit to help with the dithering. So as your pulse rate changes and as the laser head passes across, current's already kind of in play and being used by the laser with, I guess we're going to start talking about like some of the I guess AI and enhanced abilities of the RE3 system, where it's doing a lot of the calculation for you.
Yeah, that calculation has already been made.
And so that's kind of why RE3 kind of stands apart from a lot of other laser control software. Even like a LaserWorks, the new version 8 has it was a great upgrade for LaserWorks, but it really doesn't do most of what RE3 does in the sense of like setting up your file for you a bit, especially with photos. You notice a big difference when you're loading. All right, so...